It's another edition of Kaleidoscope on Channels Television. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Anne Nwawadu. On the program today, we speak with the Managing Director and Regional Executive of Ecobank, Patrick Akinwuto, on what makes Ecobank unique. We also speak with the Group Managing Director of Red Star Express, a licensee of FedEx, on the corporate social responsibility initiatives of the organization. Once again, welcome to the program. It operates in over 30 countries across Africa and other parts of the world. Let's find out more about the Pan-African Bank.
Incorporated as a public limited liability company on October the 7th, 1986, Ecobank Nigeria Limited is a subsidiary of Africa's leading independent banking group, Ecobank Transnational Incorporated, which was established under a private sector initiative spearheaded by the Federation of West African Chambers of Commerce and Industry with the support of the Economic Community of West African States, ECOWAS. In the early 1980s, the banking industry in West Africa was dominated by foreign and state-owned banks. There were hardly any commercial banks in West Africa owned and managed by the African private sector. ETI was founded with the objective of filling this vacuum. Following the successful acquisition of Ashonic Bank International by the Ecobank Group in 2011, Ecobank Nigeria has become a top-tier bank in terms of assets, customer base, deposits and branches. The bank currently operates a consolidated online real-time branch network in over 600 locations across the country. The Ecobank Group serves about 24 million customers in the consumer, commercial, and corporate banking sectors across 33 African countries. The group has banking license in France and representative offices in Addis Ababa, Ethiopia, Johannesburg, Beijing, China, London, and Dubai. Ecobank's unique and largest Pan-African platform is designed to help unlock the opportunities of the continent through standardization, fueling regional integration, trade and investment across borders.
Let's have a chat with the Managing Director and Regional Executive of Ecobank, Patrick Akinwuto.
Let me begin by congratulating you for winning the Asian Bank Award for Best Retail Bank in Nigeria. How does this make you feel?
Well, it is really nice to see that our efforts, particularly in Nigeria, is being recognized. We've always been recognized across the continent. We won Best Retail Bank in Africa, that's Ecobank, in 2018, 2019 at the Africa Bankers Awards. We've also been Most Innovative Bank in Africa, severally. We've also been the most recognized digital bank in Africa. That was by Global Finance last year. As a Pan-African bank, we have many laurels, both in the corporate banking space, in the retail banking space, in the innovation space. And we're proud that this has been made possible by our customers, by our staff, by governments that support us all across Africa. But it's a call for us to do even much more. Finally, thanks to God, it's all by His work.
You won the Best Retail Banker in Africa in the year 2016. Tell me, what really drives you?
Wow. Well, my background, personally, my dad is a teacher. My mother was a small retailer. So I learned the value of credit to growing the capacity of hardworking business women. I speak to what my mother was. She's late now. But the fact is that I saw that each time she had the required support to be able to expand her business, her ability to deliver was more or less guaranteed. So I trained as a chartered accountant. And somewhere in my career, I had the opportunity to review a bank. And I saw very quickly that perhaps I can add a lot of value.
Now, what makes Ecobank a unique African, not just African, Nigerian brand?
Well, Ecobank is indeed unique. At the beginning, we started out as a banking group with shareholders from 16 countries from day one, primarily countries in ECOWAS sub-region, but with a vision to build a world-class Pan-African bank. So from day one, we started out as a Pan-African bank, not as a country-based brand that expanded into Africa. We are very unique in that respect. And we used to joke in the early 90s that you could walk in five countries in a day, only in Ecobank. Now, fast forward, we're currently in 35 countries in Africa. Actually, beyond the AU, it's going to be difficult to find any other institution that has more coverage across Africa. In fact, I can say we are next to AU in coverage of Africa. We pioneered quite a number of things in Nigeria. For instance, we were the first to issue an international payment card in Nigeria, the Ecobank MasterCard, which was introduced in 2004 with the support of the central bank. But we dared to ensure that we play to global standards in Nigeria. We introduced a digital remittance product available for all Africans, the Ecobank Rapid Transfer. It is unique to us. The large corporates that we serve are able to do payments across the network in Africa, see their position at any point in time from our Ecobank Omni platform. At the individual level, we have arguably the most unique mobile app in banking, perhaps globally. That's the uniqueness of Ecobank. And today, we have more than 12 million users on that app. Of course, we also have the USSD platform, which in Nigeria is *326#, is also unique because that 326 means ECO, ECHO. And I'm yet to find which other bank has a string or a mobile string that is equal to the name of the bank. That's the uniqueness of Ecobank, making life better for Africans, making the economic climate of Africa better, empowering people to take their destiny in their hands, placing Africa at the forefront of global commerce.
Our Ecobank organizes a sustainability week, which shows your commitment to environmental sustainability. I mean, you had a plan to clear 4 million plastic bottles off drainages in Lagos. How far have you gone with achieving this? And what are you doing to ensure environmental safety around you?
Environmental safety is a big deal for us at Ecobank. And so driving around, going to our various branches, is very easy to see the challenges posed by plastic bottles all around the place. We challenged ourselves that how do we do this whilst also having other benefits? So we decided to launch the 4 million plastics collection campaign last year. And we actually gained very good momentum just before the famous COVID-19 came around. We had collected 2.7 million bottles and we had to pause because of the COVID and the various protocols attached to it, but we'll resume very shortly. We expect to resume before the end of the year. But the major side benefits, apart from cleaning the gutters or opening the pathway for water to flow, as you would see during this rainy season, we believe strongly that part of the bottles we removed aided in reducing the number of incidences of overflooding all around the metropolis, but also provided employment because we were paying per kilogram of the plastics that was brought in by anybody from the general public. And very quickly, a lot of the unemployed in particular saw it as an opportunity to not only add to the quality of the environment, but also earn money in this process. And we're quite pleased with that. We also saw that people were interested in the education part of it, the advocacy. So we saw an opportunity, and we took that training to secondary schools to explain to secondary school students the challenges with having plastic thrown all around the place, or the makeup of plastic, and how that can be recycled into chairs, into bed or desks. And a lot of the young ones were very creative. We actually had a competition among some schools and gave awards for unique innovation coming from the students. But in addition to this, we also have the collaboration with the Lagos Waste Management Agency, where we joined them to clean the waterfronts in Lagos. And we did that last year. And we're set to do that this year also, again before COVID, and we remain committed. Beyond this, we actually have an annual EcoBank Day event that is done across the entire network. And this year is the 8th year of the EcoBank Day, which is dedicated to giving back to the society. So in the past, we've done renovation of primary schools. In the past, we've done cleaning up of garages, planting of trees, but last year we decided to focus on non-communicable diseases, NCDs. Last year we actually did a work for bringing consciousness to better management of cancer and early detection and prevention of cancer as much as possible. So we gave free checkups to members of the public. We created enough education on health habits to avoid as much as possible. This year, we're focusing on better management of diabetes. As you know, the workforce in Africa, and particularly in Nigeria, is challenged by the high number of diabetic cases. We also have the Eradicate Malaria program that we've done across the group. And we continue to do so. We've been focusing on not necessarily the major headline items, but items that have high impact. And we adopted that during the COVID-19 pandemic. When it started, or when the index case was identified in Nigeria, we decided that we would focus on the prevention. So we did campaigns across about 50 radio stations in various local languages. We launched what was called the Stay Safe Nigeria campaign on social media, on radio. Of course, as a bank, we also joined in the CACOVID donations. We really take seriously the feedback that we've seen in respect of that.
And where do you see EcoBank going to in the future in terms of your commitment to your communities around you and your commitment to business?
Thank you. We consider that we're the face of Africa when you talk of financial services. And therefore, we rededicate ourselves to playing to world-class standards. Financial inclusion remains a major agenda for us. It is, interestingly, a major agenda for the government of Nigeria and the Central Bank. We continue to implement our young graduates program called the Graduate Trainee and the Management Trainee Program. The CIBN has recognized our focus on capacity building, particularly for the young graduates. We remain committed to our small and medium-scale entrepreneurs. They are the engine of growth. They create the employment that we so desire in Nigeria. And then at the higher level, we're more focused on the export potential of Nigeria. So working with the multinationals, Nigeria has every potential to become the export giant of Africa beyond crude oil, and we remain committed to the welfare of our customers through our various services and CSR, and to our people through giving them a chance to get to the top.